Hi everyone, I'm Kabila. There are four stitches involved in the twilight top of V Crochet magazine issue 3. In this video, I'm going to show how the extended Tunisian puff stitch is worked. If you're going to incorporate this stitch into any other project, you're going to have the stitch count as multiples of 2 plus 2 end stitches. So for demonstrating, I have 14 stitches on hand. So there'll be 12 working stitches for the puff stitch and 2 end stitches. After the foundation row, to begin the next row, we have to chain 1. Since it's an extended stitch, we are chaining 1 at the beginning of the row as well as at the end of the row. We are going to skip the first stitch and going to work on the second stitch. Insert a hook as if to Tunisian knit stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop. Yarn over, insert into the same stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop. Do that 2 more times, yarn over, insert into the same stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop. Yarn over, insert into the same stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop. So, one stitch has 7 loops. Yarn over, pull through all 7 loops. Chain 1. So this is how one extended puff stitch is made. So to continue, you're going to skip 1 and work 1, skip 1, work 1. So I'm skipping the next stitch and going to work on the other stitch. Yarn over, pull up a loop. Yarn over into the same stitch, yarn over, pull up a loop, and 2 more times. And yarn over, pull through all 7 loops, chain 1. So I'm going to do the same and complete the row. I'm at the end of the row, so as usual, you're going to pick up a loop on the end stitch and chain 1. And for the return pass, you're going to add an extra chain at all the skipped stitches. So to start, yarn over, pull through 1, yarn over, pull through 2. And here is a skip stitch, so I'm chaining 1 and yarn over, pull through 2, another skip stitch, so chain 1, yarn over, pull through 2, chain 1, pull through 2. Chain 1 and pull through 2. So we have worked the return pass. So to work the next row, we are going to work a puff stitch on all the missed stitches of the row below. Chain 1 to begin the row. Then this is a skip stitch in the previous row. So we are going to work a puff stitch next to this. Then again, in the chain 1 space of the return pass, I would like to mention a point here. To work a puff stitch on the second row or the consecutive rows, there are 4 options. There are 2 chains between the 2 puff stitches of the previous row. You can either work in this bar or the back bump of the chain. You can either work in this chain or that chain, but whatever you choose, you have to be consistent and repeat that throughout the row and as well as throughout all the rows, so that the placement of each puff stitch will be regular, consistent, and looks good. So I'm continuing the row. I'm at the end of the second row, so we have to pick up a loop on the end stitch. So for that, we're going to pick up on the second chain here. And now we'll pull up a loop, chain one. So we are going to work the return pass of this row. And now we'll pull through one. Here's a skip stitch, so a chain one for that. And yarn over, pull through 2, chain 1, through 2, chain 1, through 2, chain 1, through 2, chain 1, there's no skip stitch here, so pull through 2. So this is how we work the extended Tunisian puff stitch. And as I've mentioned before, the stitch is a multiple of 2 stitches and multiples of 2 rows. The third row will be similar to the row 1, fourth row will be similar to the row 2. So it's a 2 row repeat. Thanks for watching and see you in another video.